This is Hetu and welcome back to ETL QL Labs. I hope that you all are doing great. All right. So guys, today we are going to start this questions that we have actually collected on Ask Me Anything video. Basically, what I ask you guys to basically comment your question, ask your question in the comment section of this particular video. And then I promised you that I will take up all those questions one by one and then start doing the videos, right, for to answer your question, right? So in that series, we are doing the first question today, and I will highly recommend you guys to go and kind of comment your question on this video, because this video's whole purpose, Ask Me Anything, this purpose of this video is basically to collect the questions from many of you, right? Whoever want to ask question or whoever have faced the question in interviews, don't shy away from that. Go and ask your question. Doesn't matter whether it is a small question, big question, silly question, whatever, right? So just go and ask the question and then I'll be able to pick up your questions, right? So I'll also put this video on the I button of this particular video, okay? Ask Me video, so you can actually go and refer it, all right? Okay, now let's try to take up this first question and try to understand a little deeper about what exactly this question is, right? So this Ashok Rajan has asked this question, right? The question is, what is difference between inbound and outbound, right? Inbound and outbound files. And the second question he has asked is, what is difference between upstream and downstream file? Basically, seems like if you look at on the very high level, seems like inbound and upstream same, and outbound and downstream are same, right? Seems like, but there is a very subtle difference that we will be talking about it now. Okay, so what is that difference? Let's try to before understanding this thing, right, let me draw a little bit of ETL architecture or ETL process flow, right? That will be really helpful to understand basically what exactly it is, right? So let me quickly draw this. Okay, so what I want is basically let me draw it here. Okay, what I can do, I can just literally draw one, bear with me with my drawing skill. Okay, all right, so this is my API, this is my files, right, flat files, and this is my database. All right, these are my source systems, right? Source systems. All right, now we have something called ETL here, right? This is my ETL layer. Okay, as I said, bear with me with my drawing skill, and now I'm going to load here. Okay, this is my data warehouse. And there could be also some file extracts, right? So file extract also I'm generating out of this, right? So maybe something like this, guys. Okay, all right, so these are my extract, this is my extract process, right? And this is my major transformation layer, right? Transformation layer. All right, here what I'm doing is I'm just collecting all these data sources, right? And then I'm putting into, again, maybe one staging area, right? Here this is staging area. This is my staging area. Then I'm just trying to do some filter basically, okay? Some filter, okay? After filter, I'm just going to do some aggregation logic here, okay? And then after that aggregation, I'm just trying to load it basically. So if you look at it, this is stage area, right? This is filter area, right? And this is aggregation area, aggregation, right? So if you look at it, like this is flowing like this pipeline, isn't it? Now let's try to understand what exactly I mean to say inbound and outbound. Now guys, it is very clear. So looking at this diagram, okay, looking at this diagram, what I want to explain you guys is basically, okay, let me take different color. Okay, now when I say inbound, right, so two questions. First, let's try to understand what is inbound first, right? Inbound is everything, all the files, inbound files are all those files which are actually coming to ETL process, right? So where is ETL process, guys? This is my ETL process, isn't it? This is my ETL process. Everything which are coming, like, so you can say literally the inbound files are those files which are actually coming as a feed to ETL process. Like all of these are basically inbound. So this literally you can call them, these are basically inbound files, right? Inbound files. Okay, all the sources which are coming to ETL process as part of extraction are basically inbound files. What is what is outbound file then? Outbound file are the one which are actually going outside ETL process. So these are basically outbound files, basically, I can say. It can be database, it can be files, but these are the outbound file basically, right? Outbound files, we can say these are outbound process, outbound files, right? So everything which is going out from the ETL process, this is my ETL process, entire thing is my ETL process, no? This basically here is processing happening, everything. So everything which is going out is basically outbound file. That is the simple definition, guys, okay? That is simple definition. Now, second question is basically what is upstream and downstream, right? Now, let me take different color as well here so that, you know, okay, let me take this color. I think it's a good one. Okay, let me, I think I can take this color rather. Okay, fine. Okay, now, second question is what is upstream and downstream, right? Now, I want to tell you, it is not actually inbound as upstream, right? Obviously, one of the upstream is this as well, okay? Upstream is this as well. This is upstream for this particular process. So this is my ETL process. For my ETL process, this is upstream, okay? Though all those files are basically upstream for my ETL process. Now again, within this ETL process, let's say for aggregation, for this particular stage, this is my state, right? This is where my data is right now, okay? So for this particular data, for this particular process to happen, what is my upstream? My upstream is just immediate one, right? This is my upstream. Upstream is basically from where I am getting immediate data, isn't it? So everything for state, like for this aggregation state, for this particular process to happen, aggregation to happen, everything coming before is basically upstream, isn't it? Because it is basically upstream. It is coming, it is fetching the data from all those. So this is upstream also, right? This is also upstream. This is also upstream, isn't it? Everything is upstream for this. What is downstream? Again, similar thing. For this particular process, aggregation process, for example, what is downstream? Downstream is basically all those systems which are consuming the data from here. So this is also downstream. Okay, downstream. This is also downstream. All right. So hope you got little bit understanding about this, right? Because see, inbound and outbound files are very, very clear which are actually going out of ETL process and which is actually before the ETL process, right? Those are inbound files. But in case of upstream and downstream, there could be multiple upstream based on where you are in the stage of the process. For example, now what is the upstream for the staging area, right? So I can say, okay, for staging area, what is my upstream? Upstream is basically this process, right? This process, basically all these database files, API files, everything, whatever is coming, these are basically upstream for staging area, isn't it? For filter area, what is upstream? This is also one of the upstream for it because it is coming before it, right? So before it, whatever all the process happening before that particular process are the upstream, and whatever process happening after that particular process, for example, after filter, this is downstream, this is downstream, this is downstream. Hopefully, this is giving you clear idea, right? And this is basically the whole, process, right? So I try to explain you. Hopefully this is making sense, right? So again, if you have any other question, do let me know, okay? I will say that if you have any questions, guys, don't shy away from asking the question. You go and straight away, go hit like this video and go and ask basically your question there. I will be picking up all your questions. I have no problem clarifying. Even if I'm able to clarify your silly doubts also, I'll be happy, more than happy, right? That's the whole purpose of this channel, right? So that's all for this video, and I'll see you soon with another topic that I'll be picking up, guys. But again, I'm putting this particular video, ask me anything ETL testing on the I button, right? So you go and watch that particular video. And also, kind of, you know, you ask your question. I mean, this is the video, right? This is the way to collect the question and answer from you guys. I did not find any other way, right? That is the reason I created this video. And you can also go and review other people's questions basically there, right? And that will give you a lot of idea as well, right? Like, okay, what are these are the questions that people might be asking, right? So that is the reason, okay? And yeah, so that's all for this video, guys, okay? Very interesting questions. I will be taking up each of them, and that's my promise, right? So yeah. let's kind of continue this journey and keep ourselves upskilling, right? All right. So see you soon with the next video, guys. Until then, bye. Happy learning. God bless you.